Comedians.
I'm not dragging nobody's names.
I'm not saying
I played nobody's names in this.
Listen, you about to get us dragged in the comment section. What up, what up, what up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is What the Fuck? What happened?
Start over.
What up, what up, what up, what up?
Now you can say you're the Mademoiselle.
We gotta do that over.
Okay, wait.
What up, what up, what up? I'm the Mademoiselle, and this is
her channel.
And today we are going to be talking about something I've been wanting to talk about for a while. Because I don't know if it's just me that feel like that. I don't know if other people feel this way. But I was just like, we need to have this discussiones, okay? And the discussion topic is, are Haitian comedians funny anymore? I don't think Haitian comedians are funny like that no more. Like, I feel like a couple people started doing something and everyone else carried on and then just did the same exact shit, and it's just the same shit. I'm sorry, the Haitian accent's not funny anymore all the time. Like, sure, I talk in Haitian accent all the time. There's nothing wrong with that.
Wait. Pause.
It's overdone.
Pause. Just recently, we did the whole trying to talk like that crazy lady at the doctor's office.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you're gonna do it in that aspect, yeah.
It's different.
But it's not your only way of getting people to.
If that's like your only gimmick.
Haitian accent all the time? No.
It's annoying. You can't do that. You see, it just came out.
My sister.
Oh. You know what?
We can edit that one out. But that's one in particular.
Yeah, you know, you're right. Like, it's no problem talking with an accent, whether it be a Haitian accent, a Dominican accent, a Jamaican accent, whatever.
Okay, wait.
But that can't be your only thing that makes you funny.
If the accent is truly yours, the accent is truly
that
yours.
That too. Some people, like, they just talk like that.
If you're going to use that to be funny, okay, it works sometimes, but all the time?
Yeah.
Give us something else.
You can. And then the constant mom skits.
Only two people, they could do the mom skits all the time, and I could still laugh. Because the mom skits, they're true. They really are. They're accurate.
They're the same exact ones
okay,
all the time.
They're accurate.
When going to church, when bringing home a bad grade. Come on.
Who are you watching?
Every Haitian comedian. And they all do this. I'm not naming no names.
Name a name.
Let's just say.
Name a name.
They all do the same fucking skits.
I'll name a name.
Go ahead.
All right, so Success Junior.
I love him. Sorry, that's
like him.
I like him.
His mom skits are always
but
on
this is
point.
The thing.
He's
that's
never
one of
doing
the
same one.
That's what you need
that's
to understand.
That's what I'm saying. There's
like,
only
see?
Two comedians that can do the mom skits, and I'll keep watching them.
Exactly.
And Success Junior.
If you're the original, it is no problem. There's a couple originals.
Because he's like, not gonna repeat the same skit he already did.
Exactly. I mean, they don't. It's not that they repeat their own skits, but they repeat each other's shit.
No, they're repeating somebody else's skit. They repeat Success Junior's skit, basically.
Pretty much. Like, they'll sit there and try to spin it. Like, bitch, or they'll do, like, a Haitian father. And it's like,
no. I only respect Junior and Junior's mom, okay?
Facts.
So. Junior's mom is hilarious.
But he is so cute.
Junior's mom is
my
mom.
I feel like he was one of the very first ones that was successful doing it. Not very first, but one of the first couple people that started doing
it.
He
did the Junior's mom. And Junior's mom is on point. And Junior's mom is really every Haitian mom to an extent. So it was funny.
But you can't just sit there and rip somebody's shit off and you consider that comedy.
What did Drake say? Never let a N-word ride your wave. I keep trying to tell you. I'm not going to say. Do you get demonetized from me saying that?
I don't know at this point. I get demonetized from being myself. Cursing, not cursing.
The N-word.
Bitch.
We have kids.
Anyway.
Never let a nigga ride your wave. And these niggas out here riding somebody else's wave trying to make it up. Okay, what works for that one person?
It's not
gonna work for you.
Even I've done Haitian skits before. There's nothing wrong with it. But you can't constantly do the same exact type of shit. Haitian mom, Haitian dad, Haitians be like.
We got it.
Could we please end that? Like, that whole Haitians be like shit is just not funny anymore. It's very annoying.
But the Haitians really do be like that.
Exactly, but I've seen at least 20,000 videos of the same Haitians be like. And then you're not even that successful to be copying people.
Sorry, nobody said you had to say all that.
I'm sorry. Like, if you're gonna copy other people's shit, you better make sure you get the views, bitch. You better make sure you get the views. You better make sure you get the clout.
See, I'm not close to that.
I'm sorry. I don't need a cosign for that. It's true shit. You can't copy somebody else's shit and you're not successful.
I have to put this disclaimer out so they don't come for me in the comments. So I said, oh, y'all sound. They gonna say y'all. Yeah, y'all sound. Right. Y'all did this.
Because people came at me at the other video for your comments.
Because I say something. No, see, she said it. Come for her.
Word. Before, but yeah, let's throw this disclaimer in there. Before anyone gets upset and they're like, oh, Haitians always gotta tear other Haitians down. You know,
it's not
bitch,
like
bitch, bitch.
It's not like
click
that.
Off.
I want all my Haitians to succeed, but that's at the same time, you have to know I'm here to help you.
Not even that.
Sometimes take these tips. You need to be willing to be open to taking other people's suggestions, advice, and what other people are seeing. Because at the end of the day, we're the ones watching these little videos. And if we're not here to click on your fucking videos, what are you making the video for?
Not only that, I feel like people like think that just because you're part of a country or part of something, you can't say anything negative about them. I don't understand.
I don't get it.
But if it was a white
person, I should be the one who could give you the negative.
But if it was a white person, what were you gonna say?
When the white person go and say, "Oh, they're racist." Okay, so when I say it, what does that make me a hater? No, I'm here trying to help you. You dumb bitch.
So,
let me rephrase. You dumb person. Demonetized for that.
No, like seriously, I'm absolutely over it. I'm tired of those comments. Like, if you really think that everything is all peachy with your country or your whatever the hell you're part of, then you're absolutely mistaken. Just because I'm American doesn't mean I can't say stupid shit about
like
America.
Like I said, the Haitians should stop moving out. And
people were very upset about that.
First of all, that does not mean I'm not pro Haitians trying to get up there, trying to do better for themselves. But they're not leaving to better themselves. They're leaving to go get free shit. And my question is, when did you lose the... I don't even know what the word is. When did you lose your little pride? Your integrity, your pride, your sense of work, your value, your work ethic. That you stop working for what you want and trying to get on somebody else's back to get free shit to make it through life. It don't work like that. Sometimes you have to work stuff yourself. Same thing with these people in the videos. You have to come with an original idea. Come with your own point of view to something. Don't copy the first person exactly. Come with your own point of view to it.
Mind you, everything anyone says is subjective. Like, at the end of the day, this is not every single Haitian.
No, it's not.
Not every single comedian.
No, it's not.
This is absolutely
just
a general
thing
basis.
So you guys could be aware. When you watch somebody's video, even if you're not watching it and somebody just turns it on, they should be able to say, oh, that's such and such. Oh, is that Success Junior? Because I've done that before and it turns out it's not Success Junior.
Like, if you're gonna do it, you gotta twist it up enough so it's yours and it's entertaining.
You don't want people to just come and say and still think of the other comedian.
There's a way to steal shit.
I don't wanna say steal, that you're
there's
taking.
There's a way to steal shit.
That you're taking.
There's a way to steal shit.
That don't cause it. Let me think of the word.
Steal shit. Like, if you're gonna copy someone's style or you're gonna admire someone's style and use it as your own, I guess that's the textbook way to say it.
That's not what I'm saying.
Better yet, if you don't steal shit,
whatever.
Make sure you make it your own.
But yeah, make it your own so people not still associating you with the person who you reference.
That's the worst thing ever, like, to be associated that way. Like,
oh, I saw such and such do that before.
This is even just on YouTube. Like, you know how many people I click on and I'm like, I know, damn well, this is Bethany Moda type shit. I know, this is Ellen type shit.
Best believe if I did something like that, I'm like, look, I got this idea from such and such.
Exactly. You need to get credit where it's due. Inspired by, you know, or something.
I would never. You see my little photography skills. They be A1.
Exactly.
I would never
copy somebody else's photography
stuff. Because, for example, I follow Brandon Wolfell. I don't know how to say his name. But he's a photographer. He has an Instagram and a YouTube page. And he does this, like, rainbow effect in his pictures on his models or whatever. I really want to try that. But the day I do try that, I'm not going to say, ooh, I came up with a new technique. I would say, oh, I was inspired by Brandon, and this is the technique, and this is my take on it.
Perfect.
So that's what I gotta do.
Yeah, there's ways
to do
shit.
Nobody cares. Just give them their credit.
And then, you know what is really funny, and I know this is gonna be, I know anyone who talks to me, because a lot of people talk to me about the issues, they probably gonna see this as shade, but it's whatever. I'm tired of Haitians complaining about other Haitians not supporting them. It gets me
mad. I don't have to support you because you're Haitian.
I'm tired of that.
I support you because I like what you're doing.
Point blank, period.
That's it.
I don't give a fuck if you're black, white, pink, green, whatever you are, it doesn't bother me. I'm not gonna support you because you're Haitian. I don't give a flying fuck.
As long as what you're pushing out, the content that you're pushing out, draws my attention and I like it and it's quality content,
that's all that
I will keep watching. I will keep following and doing whatever.
No, like I've seen a couple of Haitian comedians quit and they're like, oh, Haitians don't support me. I'm like, no, you're just not funny. You're doing the same
shit. And why do you just want the Haitians to support you? What about the other people out there?
They'll be like, oh, I'm making all these skits for the Haitians, but the Haitians aren't supporting me. I'm
and like, it's this amount of Haitians in the world
compared to the rest of the world. First of all, why they gotta support you for, like, I don't get it. I don't understand the sense of entitlement that people have to their country or their heritage. Mm-hmm. I don't see the point.
I know Haitians are all that.
Facts, like,
I don't know.
I don't say the...
They're all that, but they're not all that.
Why
have you heard, have you seen what Haitians are?
The shit.
But at the same time,
we the shit.
They're the shit and they're bougie as hell, so why don't they gotta follow you when they could follow... Intel over there.
Exactly. At the end of the day, I'm sure most Haitian people could agree that we see the same shit. These Haitian comedians do the same thing over
Haitians are Haitians. And over again. So whatever you see is happening in Junior's house is also happening in Bertha's house, and it's also happening at Manushka's house. So Bertha and Manushka don't need to come out with the same video that Junior came out, because they said, oh, my mom does that too. Okay.
Exactly.
Junior already covered it.
Exactly.
For all of us.
So next. Next. I'm sorry. They not funny. If you're gonna do something like that, you gotta tap into different markets. Yeah, you can throw a Haitian skit.
You don't see Remy out there. I think he was on a commercial or something. Remy's making moves.
I'm on a commercial. I'm gonna have to see that commercial.
John was like, oh, that's Remy. I'm like, okay.
Yeah, like that's the thing. You gotta tap into different markets if you're gonna do that type of thing, because it's already overdone, it's oversaturated, and it's not funny.
And it's not that much to do.
Exactly. Like, at least tap into different markets, but don't sit there and just do the Haitian thing and then complain when Haitians don't support you when you could have used your common sense in first.
You could be the Haitian husbands. Now they're gonna come out with Haitian wives. Haitian wives be like,
can I be part of it? I'll do that.
I think the Haitian husbands also cover the Haitian wives.
They do.
Yes.
They really do. But they should make it a group. Like, and this is not even just for
it's
Haitian.
It's not just, you don't even have to just be original.
Yes, you do.
Because, no, when you say original, it makes it seem like do something that's not done, which is hard because everything's done. You just have to
Put your own take on it.
If you're not a creator at heart, if you're not an artistic person at heart, if this is not making you, if you're not doing it just because you like to do it, don't do it.
That's true.
Because you're just going to get bored, and you're going to get tired, and you're going to copy other people's stuff.
I know a lot of people who really just do skits and stuff because they want, like, the money, they want the fame,
that
they
shouldn't
want the
be
clout.
Your
that should never be
your driving.
Motivation. It should never. First of all, you're not going to get money for a fair. Like, you're going to be very broke and very pissed off when you're not making
money. Do you know how much money I spend
on
my blog?
I spend a lot of money
on buying bullshit for my pictures. I just like taking pictures. I'm only doing it because I like to take pictures. And my pictures, every day when I take a picture, I'm like, oh my god, this picture is better than the first picture I ever took. I spend so much money on that. It's not like I'm getting a dime. I get some dimes. But it's not like I'm getting paid for it. I just started doing it because I like to do it. And I just keep doing it because I'm like, I wake up one day, oh, I want to take a picture today. All right, let me use this little moment. Somebody, cut me a check. That's it. There. Maybe I can be lucky now, you know?
This bitch. Anyhow.
Since you don't want to name no names,
we're not gonna name any names.
I have like three.
We're not gonna name any names on
one in particular that is really getting on my nerves.
We're not gonna name anybody in this video because I don't want nobody getting upset.
And that person is really getting pretty far. And I'm just like, ow!
Because people love to get butt hurt. I know people are gonna comment in the fucking shit and throw people's names in.
I mean, you guys can try to take a guess, but you're not gonna guess correctly.
Yeah, we're not gonna say who it is. I'm sure they're gonna guess correctly because
they're not gonna guess
correctly. Have you ever seen the comments on my natural hair videos and people be like, yo, I hate this YouTuber, she does the same shit.
Well,
I'm like,
they're
damn.
Who they hate, but they don't know who I'm talking about. And that's not, I'm not saying that I hate this person. I'm just saying that I wish this person would like really take a look at what they're doing and what the content they're creating and just be better, you know? At some point, you know what kind of quality you can push out, and when you push out subpar quality, your people really sit there and look at it like, what is this?
You'll still have your core group of supporters. There's people that are going to support you no matter what.
No, I'm not that person. You know, I'm not that person either. No,
as soon as you do
I'll
bullshit,
be on your photos and like, what the fuck is this?
She really do. Which what is this shit? Everyone has that core group of followers. Like,
I don't think you're making the money from that core group. I think the long run, you're making money from the people that you could continually pull in.
That's very true.
And you're not going to keep pulling in people when those people could go to the original source to get what they're looking for.
Exactly. Like, it's just, it's time.
If they can't find you and they can't see what you're bringing that's different than the other person, what's making them come over there? You wouldn't get hurt trying to ride somebody's wave.
You can get hurt trying to ride other people's wave. A lot of people that's probably hurt trying to ride this video probably were typing a mean ass comment about mad as shit.
I don't care.
And I don't either. I don't. Keep making me coin. Every comment.
It's. Why is it so hard? Why is it so hard to accept some type of feedback? Let it be negative, positive, whatever. The message is out there. You take what you need from the message. There's definitely
take
part
it
in
how
this,
you want.
There's definitely part in this message for everyone. Take the part that's meant for you. Leave the part that's not. Don't come being hurt about something that was said that wasn't meant for you. Leave that for the other person. It's gonna help them. Don't come over here fucking shit up for the next person, okay?
The end of the day, the video is posted. We said what we said.
Like, I said what I said. Put the Nene meme in here for me.
Yes.
I said what I said. Okay.
It is what it is. If you're mad, you're mad. Don't go around sending this shit and making it seem like it's something that it ain't, because it ain't.
If you're mad, you're mad. No. If you're mad, you're dumb. What are you mad at? The fuck are you mad at?
How many more views we would get if we actually threw people's names into this?
Let's tag their names.
Even about supporting your kind or not supporting your kind, it's
just
about
be a
saying
good
that ass
creator.
It's about being a good creator. It's about saying what's real and what's not
just
real. It's
it.
About calling out bullshit when bullshit need to be called.
Word.
Anyone that gets upset, that's your business. Anyone who does it, that's great. Thank you very much.
I don't know why you keep saying anybody that gets upset like it's okay. It's not
it
okay.
Is okay.
No, they're stupid. Why are you mad?
Everyone's entitled to their own.
What are you mad at?
Opinion?
No. You're entitled to your own opinion, but tell me.
You're entitled to be mad.
Sit down, talk to me. What are you mad at? What are you mad at? What did I say here that made you mad? Then we can have a discussion about that in another video. You're mad at this, why? Because I told you the truth? Because no one else around you is telling you the truth? Be mad at them because they're not telling you the truth. Not be.
This is facts.
Don't be mad at me.
This is very facts. But I'm going to say you could feel however you want to feel.
I'm not going to say that shit.
Your comment made me money. And I appreciate it.
See, you feel like that. I always get mad when you say that shit because.
What is true?
What are they mad at?
Sure.
All of y'all who took this advice. Run me my check. Cut me a check. A nice little one. It could be little.
Run my squirrel.
You know, I don't have that many bills, you know? I have a real job, so I'm not pressed for coins. So just cut me a little nice check.
Make sure you follow her blog.
Start on Instagram. Scroll through the pictures. There's nice pictures
on Instagram.
Of you.
Yeah, I need to post them. I'm waiting to take my hair out so they could all go, you know, I don't know. I didn't want to put my braids and then my hair and my braids. I'm very
busy. You get nice free little photo shoots because I have a nice little hobby
that's
that
true.
I like.
So yeah, make sure you guys follow her Instagram, follow her blog. Make sure you definitely check me out on Instagram,
yes.
Twitter, Snapchat. Look at this merchandise right here.
Can I get one for $15?
No!
Can I get an affiliate link?
No!
And get the people to
no,
buy
it? No, nigga! I'm not making no money off the crop tops at all.
No, but can I get an affiliate link?
No!
So that people can buy it on my page and
no.
I can get one free
we're not
something.
Doing that.
Set up a paper plan?
All right.
Oh
anyhow, make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, and we will see y'all.
We just talked about this shit. It's weak.
Oh God. Okay, let's start again.
Get.
Okay. Make sure you
like, share, subscribe.